Hi everybody, my name is Addison Hillman and I'm the 2024 summer intern for Stearns, Benton, Morrison, and Sherburne counties. Today I am at the North Central Research and Outreach Center where we will be doing some body condition scoring comparisons. Make sure to go watch Melissa Runk's video. She is the Ag Production Systems Extension Educator and she explains what to look for and where to look when body condition scoring. I am here to build off of her video by comparing multiple cows to get a better understanding of body condition scoring. Body condition scoring is a practical tool used to assess an animal's fat reserves. This allows the producers to change their nutritional and management strategies to meet the needs of the animal. Body condition scoring can be a subjective tool, so when it's used to analyze production systems, the same person should be doing the body condition scoring to get an accurate assessment. If a producer has a pen of cattle with a body condition score of around 3 or 4, they probably want to look at what they are doing and increase the nutritional quality or quantity of their feed. The same goes for the opposite side of the scale. Producers with a pen of cattle at a body condition score of around 7 or 8 are losing money on how much feed they are giving. Cattle have a hierarchy system in a herd, so if there is a range of body condition scores, the lower end of the hierarchy may not be getting to the bunk to fill their needs, and a producer might want to consider splitting the group into two pens. In this video, we will see three clips of three different cows, then compare them side by side to see the difference in body condition scores. Some areas to look for while watching these clips include the top line, the ribs, the hip bones and pins, and the tail head. From the videos, you could probably see a clear difference between the three, especially the first and last videos. Now looking at the body condition score 3, the hip bones are very defined and there's little muscle in the hindquarters. Now on the body condition score of 5, there is more fat coverage between the hips and the pins, and you can see a more plump rump. The body condition score of 7, she is very round and there's a lot of excess fat on the tail head. You can also see that her top line is flat across. Now seeing the body condition score of 3 at this angle, the backbone is clearly visible and you can see the last three ribs. There is no excess fat around the tail head and the bones are visible. Now the body condition score of 5 could also be called a 4. From this angle, you can still see the space between the processors. Should be considered borderline to ideal. This is also dependent on what a producer sees as ideal for their operation. Now for our body condition score of 7. She would be about of a 6 or 7, but she would be ideal condition for calving. Maybe a little fleshy, but since she has a 3-month-old calf, this is not ideal. For a review of what we learned in this video, body condition scoring is a tool that producers can use, not a requirement. Body condition scoring is subjective, meaning there's no definite right or wrong answer. The key areas to look for when body condition scoring include the top line, ribs, hip and pin bones, the tail head, and the brisket. A good question to ask when body condition scoring is there excess fat or visible bones? Times during the year when you should be body condition scoring include at breeding, right before calving, 90 days before calving, since this will allow you to add more weight before calving, then again at weaning or late summer / fall.